Hello and welcome to another Wise Option e-learning. Today we're going to be going over the contracts module, and we're kind of just going to be going over an overview of the contracts and going to go ahead and start pointing out some of the key features. Other videos here in the series are going to be going over things like adding contracts and of course some of the more detailed things that go along with this contracts module. But up here at the top of the screen, of course, we're going to go start to our contracts module. You'll see I do have a list of contracts here. So just like, of course, many other forms in Wise Option, we do have this grid view, which is great because I can create custom queries up here at the top. You can see I have several different ones. I've chosen to view all my contracts, but you, of course, might have several more than I do here and don't want to load all the hundreds and hundreds of contracts that you have. So, of course, you can create different queries to go ahead and create a different list for you to view different contracts. So of course, and same thing here with these columns, of course, I can go ahead and change the columns that I want to view with this list view settings icon here. I've chosen some of the most common ones that I think most people will want to view. But of course, for different contracts, you might want different views. So go ahead and play around with that and different sorts. You'll notice, of course, here I do also have this history icon. So I can actually go ahead and select each contract and see the history of changes for each contract from any adds, edits, anything that was added to that contract, I can see here as well. You'll also notice here, I can actually do form letters from this as well, which we're going to be going over a little bit more in an e-learning video because we're going to be talking about the exciting stuff like DocuSign that can go hand in hand with this contracts module. And so I'm going to go ahead and just click on one of these contracts here that I've created. And I'm going to go ahead and I'll click on this one here and open this contract just to give you a little bit of a layout of what these contracts look like. So it's going to load several subcategory tabs. You can see here I have contract as contract number 4, and I have 4 different tabs underneath each contract. So the first one here is the basic contract info. You can see here that I have the first thing, of course, is the status. So this one's pending. But you can see we have several other statuses. I'm going to go ahead and update that to active. Then, of course, we have the primary contract owner, any agent. If you want to put in a custom contract number, you can also see here, if I go up here, I have the contract type. And you see it's grayed out and locked. Once you save a contract, the type locks in what it is. Of course, the mayor owner, all these fields here, of course, change depending on what the type of contract you select, because, of course, these fields here won't be necessarily applicable to, let's say, just a standard mayor AI on-site breeding contract. And then, of course, we do have a yellow notes here for this contract as well. So I can, just like on the patient and the customer file, I can add yellow notes to this as well. And you'll notice down here at the bottom left corner of the screen, I have this button down here to add a linked new contract. So this is a really cool new feature that we've added with this contract module that allows you to add a new contract, but link it to this one. So let's say, for example, that you created this contract, they signed it, and halfway through the season, the mayor is just not working and they want to switch mayors. So you authorize the approval for them to switch mayors. But you'd like to maintain that history and know that, hey, the original contract was actually for Mayor so-and-so and this new one is for their new mayor. So you can create a new contract that is just linked to this old one for your records. And I'll show you on the main screen what that looks like. Of course, we love our little history icon as well to go ahead and track any changes that are made. And then, of course, we did also add progress notes. So if you wanted to go ahead and add in different progress notes for this contract, maybe sort of as a communication log, if you wanted to log any, of course, phone calls you had with the owner going back and forth, or like I said, just any sort of manual progress notes that you'd like to enter specific to this contract, you can do so there. And then, of course, we do have the form letter here as well. You can do different form letters from this. This is also where the DocuSign will come in handy, which we'll talk about in another e-learning video. And then on the next tab here, we have a list of contract charges, which again, we'll go over more in a different video, but you can actually add charges to a specific contract and then bill according to the contract ownership. And then, of course, we do have a specific contract image file, again, going hand in hand with that DocuSign integration. Or if you just need to upload any image relating to this contract, you can also do so manually. And again, there's this DocuSign status, which we'll talk more in another video. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you again real soon.